Today is going to be a good day.
I'm sure you should be back at work yet. You still look a bit rough.
Thanks a lot, Jim.
Can you see that, Keith? I think it's safe to say we're not 100% sold on it at the moment. You drive in.
Who's she?
We don't know. The paramedics found her. And once it's gone, it's gone.
I can't argue with that.
God, honestly, 2 days off, the whole place is falling apart.
Now, you can say it backwards, which is Sue Wickedelive, Sickens in a Garth and a Creepus.
She may be tricky. But she's bloody good!
There was nothing we could do. They all died so suddenly. Except this poor little soul. I suppose he'll be next to go. What are you doing?
I need your help.
What is that thing?
Please, just trust me.
Give me a hand.
Careful!
Pull his head.
What's in there?
Something belongs to him. His last breath.
What have you done to him?
Welcome back.
Good morning, Melissa.
Morning, Bob.
Morning, Danny.
Morning, Jim. Oh.
What do you think?
Oh, did you hear that Charles bloody Buxton on the radio today?
Yes, I'm afraid we did.
Oh, sorry, Jenny. Feeling better?
Much better, thanks, Minister. Anyway, here's the brief for this morning's visit.
Why don't you just tell me the main points?
Right, well, we're going to a project in Hampshire.
Hertfordshire.
Hertfordshire. And the project is kind of a building thing, helping young people with a history of offending. And the policy team thought it would be a good idea for you to be seen supporting stakeholders in conjunction with the implementation of a new EU directive.
Come on, just give me the basics. You know, where are we going? What is the project? Who are we meeting? Why are we meeting them? You know, simple questions, Jenny. Just give me simple answers.
You're right. I'll call them now. Why don't you have a look through the draft speech? I haven't had time to look through it yet. I have been ill.
Yes, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
David, it's Jenny.
I can't believe things have turned out like this.
It's going to be okay.
Is it? Everyone's going to want to know where he is.
We'll say we don't know. We'll say that he went home. Didn't say goodbye, just checked out.
I suppose they believe that. They've seen how he's been acting lately.
Exactly. It's going to be okay. At least I have it to myself for once.
He's got amnesia.
Are you sure that isn't just another word for a selective memory?
Glenn, stop it. Can you remember anything?
I remember how much I love you. And I know you love me too.
No, you're wrong. I love Glenn. My husband.
I thought James was your husband.
Minister's office? Yes, something's coming through into my inbox right now. I guess that'll be the speech for tonight's dinner, finally. Look, I'm a bit tied up right now. Can I call you back? Oh, honestly, don't know what they think we do here. The minister has to attend a dinner for the Association of Local Government Hygiene Inspectors, and this speech looks like it's been written by a Dalek. It's be an after-dinner speech, not a technical paper. Just haven't got time to go through it and make it sound human. But perhaps I can graft a few bits on to the speech he gave at the Royal Ornithology Society last week. Now, where is it? Bit of information about the association and a few changes. Feathered friends. No. Nasty diseases. Yes. Obviously. Great crested grebe. No. What's his name again?
It's Joel.
Right, okay. How about this? Joel was an orphan. When he was 6 years old,
His parents were cut up by a pimp.
What about this, then? Joel lived with his foster parents, who were nice and kind. One day, when a magic teapot came to take him away to a secret place, Joel decided he'd stay where he was. What have you got?
Joel's parents died in a car accident.
I don't mean to be melodramatic, but your ambition to be a children's author is ruining my life.
My ambition is a beautiful thing.
No, I'm a beautiful thing. Your ambition is the reason why we can't afford to go on holiday or have a baby. I've got to go. Call me later. Do you like my new shoes?
They make your feet look tiny and your head look massive.
Why don't you spend the day thinking silly thoughts, and I'll spend the day earning money and working out what to do about you and your fucking ambition.